Hello, my name is Adam Erickson, and this is my first assignment for Ferris State University's Master's in Information Systems Management, assignment number one. The video is a brief intro into database design. I will be reviewing a simple database that I have created and covering database design standards, normalization designs, referential integrity, indexes, and primary keys, along with a few other things. The database is called Certification Records. It is a database that would probably be used by larger companies like Google, Intuit, a database where consultants who need certification can have that certification recorded with human resource so they can track time with classes, certifications, and how much they've been paying. That's pretty much where this database begins, and it could be expanded upon in the future. For this assignment, only 5 database tables were necessary, so I cut it off short.
Okay, let's start with normalization. Normalization is the process of organizing data in a database. This includes creating tables and establishing relationships between those tables according to rules designed both to protect the data and to make the database more flexible by eliminating two factors, redundancy and inconsistent dependency. Redundant data wastes disk space and creates maintenance problems. If data that exists in more than one place must be changed, the data must be changed in exactly the same way in all locations. A customer's address change is much easier to implement if that data is stored only in the customer table and nowhere else in the database. There are a few rules for database normalization. Each rule is called a normal form. First normal form, also called atomic. In first normal form, it dictates that for every row by column position in a given table, there exists only one value, not an array of lists of values. An example would be right here where I have city, state, and zip. If lists of values are stored in a single column, there is no simple way to manipulate those values. Retrieval of data becomes much more laborious and difficult to generalize. Those should actually broke out in the table. One column for city, one column for state, one column for zip. Second normal form, no repeating groups. Again, under training center space bad, which is not how you want to name things, we'll get that later. You say have phone, phone 2, and phone 3. If you're going to have repeating groups, you should break those off into a separate table, maybe just a table called phone. That is second normal form. Third normal form, no redundancies. Everything should depend on the key as it is. So also in this bad table I created just for an example, you'll see we also have certifications and classes. That is redundant data because we have a class table and a certification table. Redundant data means that if I was to change the certification and the class, I'd also have to go into this table and change it also. And another obvious example of a dependency is a calculation column. For example, now that we have the cost for classes and the cost for tests, and I wanted to find what the total that a consultant had spent on a yearly record for those two classes, and I entered a total column here, it would have to write out the total every time I changed the costs, and it would be redundant. You should actually save that for a query. Next, let's discuss indexes. An index is a separate file that is sorted and contains only fields you're interested in sorting on. If you create an index on, let's say, certification name, like I have, a SQL database can find the corresponding record very quickly. Indexes work in a very similar way to an index in a book. Imagine paging through a technical book, or more often, a scrambled pile of notes looking for the topic on optimizing a SQL database. An index saves you an immense amount of time. Other indexes that I have put is under consultant name, consultant first name and last name. Another rule is you should not have more than 3 on a table, because for each time that you write information to that table, if you had four indexes on top of just the information on that table, you'd actually have to write five times, and that could start to slow the database down after a while. Let's now go to primary and foreign keys. There are two types of keys, primary and foreign. Both of them can be created when you create the table or after the fact, as long as you don't violate any of the rules that you've placed in effect. The concept of a primary key is pretty simple. It's a value or a set of values that makes a particular row or record in a table unique. While working in Visio, everything that's bold above the first line here with the PK next to it is my primary key. An inner joining table like class center here that joins class and training center uses the primary ID from each table together to form the primary key for class center. This also breaks the many-to-many relationship, which you do not want to have either for redundant reasons. The primary key of a table has to be unique. A primary key can be made up of several columns, because sometimes one column alone does not make a row unique, like class center. This type of primary key is also called a composite key, because it's made up of several columns. While primary key enforces entity integrity, as I explained earlier, foreign keys are used to enforce referential integrity. Referential integrity guarantees that references from one table to another are enforced by the database, and not just in queries. From here, it could be also enforced by constraints or triggers. Another thing that I need to go over with you today is called data types. In a SQL Server, each column has its own data type. It is an attribute that specifies the type of data that an object can hold. Usually it is an integer or a character. It could be monetary, date, time, binary, and there's a lot more, but we're not going to go into that depth right now. When two expressions that have different data types or length are combined by an operator, the characteristics of those results can be determined, but I'd have to go way too far into depth for an intro to database discussion. Basically, if cost here was an integer and cost here was a character, that would be like trying to add a plus 1, which would equal 2 probably, because it's only one character. But what you want to try to do is keep it like I have. I use both my cost fields as decimal. Visio automatically makes it 10, 2, which would be 10 decimals to the left, 2 decimals to the right, which can be used for monetary value also. 10 is like $1 million, and I don't think any class or test is going to cost that much, but I cannot change the 10. This pretty much sums up data types, indexes, normalization, and primary and foreign keys. Classes, and applications, not address. That covers first, second, third, and form. Name mentions for today is class. Is an uppercase class, no space, center, both C's capitalized. This is referred to as camel case. Also in columns, same as the table names, are in lowercase, and the first character of each word is in uppercase. There are no spaces between words. Certification name, capital C, certification, capital N, name, no space in between. Today I have shown an overview of relational database theory, or normalization. I have tried to the best that I can to explain keys, data types, and index decisions. Oh well, I haven't really decided, I haven't told you why I've chosen to index name and first name, but usually because they're quicker to find. If you have a problem finding someone, you usually ask, well, what's your last name? And then when you pull up their last name, you might find that there's, my last name is Erickson, there's 4 Ericksons. So then you ask what the first name is, and you find out that there's only one Adam Erickson. You can go into depth if you were to actually ask for their social security number or birth date also. The only table I can actually use this transfer shows everything that you don't want to do. So I will be removing it before I finish this tutorial. Training Center Band also has improper naming conventions. The primary key is an address. Well, if the address is a building and there's four companies in the building, that doesn't make a good primary key. I have also decided to mess up all three normal forms inside one table. It'd be easier to just get rid of that table and not have it connect to anything. And that concludes my preview of database design. Thank you for watching and have a nice day.